Greece is the third and last country of the trio presidency, consisting of Ireland, Lithuania and Greece. In July 14, we will hand the presidency over to Italy. On the 1st of January, we assumed for the fifth time the rotating presidency of the EU Council. The presidency budget is no more than 50 million. During the presidency, Greece will host in Athens 14 informal ministerial meetings, plus the Gymnich informal ministerial meeting, as well as about 110 other low-level meetings. 2014 is a year of important changes and new beginnings for the European Union. First of all, 2014 will witness the start of a new seven-year macroeconomic programming period under the Multiannual Financial Framework for 2014 to 2020. Secondly, it will witness the holding of elections for a new European Parliament in May. Finally, as the year drives to its close, the appointment of a new European Commission will take place in October, followed by the appointment of a new European Council President in November 2014. This year we also be marked by the midterm review of the Europe 2020 strategy, as well as the continuation of the work to complete and deepen the European Monetary Union. In addition to all above mentioned challenges, Greece assumes the presidency at a time that the EU is in a deep crisis. The extent of the debt crisis and of the associated recession and unemployment has undermined the confidence of EU citizens in the very idea of European integration, and as a result, social cohesion has suffered enormously, in particular in the countries where the effects of the crisis have been more pronounced. We have to deal with the wave of Euroscepticism, and we should try hard to convince anyone concerned that the solution lies on more and not on less Europe. To overcome the hiatus, we need more European integration. Moreover, we need good jobs and sustainable growth, and we must ensure that our policies are aligned with this popular demand. These aspirations are shared by the Hellenic presidency, and our political priorities were formulated in order to reflect and serve these goals. The period of the Hellenic presidency will also be pivotal in Greece at a time when the first signs of an exit from the crisis are becoming discernible, a crisis that has caused the Greek economy a cumulative recession of 25% of GDP, with unemployment rates mushrooming, particularly for the young, and where the average Greek has lost 40+% of the living standard. Thanks to the persistent efforts and sacrifices of the Greek people, Greece has taken major strides in the direction of fiscal health, showing the best structural primary surplus in the Eurozone at over 6% of GDP, and has also achieved a deficit reduction of 13% of current GDP. There are good grounds for optimism that the 6 months of the Hellenic presidency will coincide with the recovery of Greece's real economy. The main principles which will guide the work of the presidency are the promotion of policies and measures for achieving growth, combating unemployment, promoting economic and social cohesion and structural reforms, deepening integration and completion of the European Monetary Union, as well as addressing external challenges, including EU enlargement. Let me now present you the priorities of the Hellenic presidency about growth, jobs and cohesion. Unemployment has reached record high rates in most EU member states, affecting especially the young, and recession is a constant threat to European economies. From the Greek perspective, jobs and growth are structurally and inextricably connected. Initiatives for halting unemployment and boosting job creation are absolutely necessary in order to avert the danger of jobless growth. The main objective is to balance the timetable of fiscal consolidation with the implementation of a substantially enhanced and realistic compact for growth and jobs, which can be transformed into a diverse European investment program, model after the cohesion policy with a focus on employment. This includes inter alia, first, dealing with pending legislative work to implement the growth-oriented sector of the multi-annual financial framework. Secondly, implement decisions made by the June 2013 European Council concerning increasing the lending capacity of SMEs, the key employers of the European economy, and creating a friendly environment for their growth. Thirdly, implement the Youth Initiative in order to create jobs for the most vulnerable part of our population. Fourth, initiative talks on further promoting mobility in the job market. Fifth, taking action on external trade through further promoting ongoing talks on trade agreement with the US and other strategic partners. Sixth, the interim evaluation of the Europe 2020 strategy at the spring 2014 European Council lends the context and offers the opportunity for more concrete initiatives on growth and jobs creation. And seventh, promoting measures on dealing with the social consequences of our decisions on European Monetary Union. For us, easing liquidity for Europe's SMEs, especially at the periphery, including young innovative companies, will help boosting employment for our youth and create the conditions for sustainable and competitive growth. The financing of these companies should be diversified to also include non-banking channels, building on existing European proposals, such as the Commission's Green Paper and the High-Level Group Report on Financing Growth. Promoting investment is the main condition to combating unemployment in a sustainable way. Therefore, exploring ways to restore normal lending to the real economy is among the most ambitious priorities of our presidency. We will remain focused on all the parameters affecting lending to business, mainly SMEs financing, as well as longer-term funding. In this respect, we are working on the Joint Commission European Investment Bank Initiative on SMEs financing. We strongly wish to have your assistance in taking further the discussion regarding alternative sources of funding the real economy. Now, about further integration of the EU Eurozone. The global financial crisis revealed the great extent to which the fiscal policies of the Eurozone member states are intertwined. Furthermore, it made clear the absence of preventive and corrective structures in the original economic and monetary union architecture, which would absorb the shocks within the member states and would deter any threat to the macroeconomic stability of the euro area. The course towards a deep and genuine economic and monetary union requires an integrated financial, fiscal, and economic framework. This exercise should be consistent with and devote special attention to the social dimension and the democratic legitimacy and accountability of the new economic and monetary union. The main objective is to safeguard the stability of the common currency by advancing the deepening of the European Monetary Union and the ex-ante coordination of national fiscal and economic policies. In this framework, progress on the following building blocks will be emphasized. One, the promotion of the banking union. The Hellenic presidency will strive to reach agreement on the Commission's latest proposal on the single resolution mechanism, and has already taken responsibility for trilogues, that is the dialogue between or a conversation between the Council of Ministers, EU Parliament and EU Commission, for the adoption of a directive before the dissolution of the EU Parliament in April, according with the time frame of the EU leaders in the European Union Council. Depending on recent progress, we might face other issues that seem ripe for agreement, such as the banking recovery, the resolution directive, and the deposit guarantee directive. Sorry. At the same time, there is special interest in promoting as a matter of urgency, given the small legislative period until the elections for the European Parliament, issues concerning... Thank you. Issues concerning tax fraud and tax evasion, as well as the financial transactions tax. Thank you. 2. Agreement on the principles of the reinforced budgetary and economic integration frameworks. The aim is to ensure the effective implementation and further integration of new EU Eurozone economic governance mechanism so as to enhance synergies between member states in a growth and jobs friendly way. Our work will be guided by Herman Van Rompuy's roadmap and the Commission's blueprint. The new Eurozone should fully respect the single market and remain open to non-Euro area member states. 3. Special emphasis will be attached to the social dimension of the European Monetary Union as one of the pillars for its further deepening. Greece strongly supports the Banking Union and the Single Resolution Mechanism. With strong European support, which could be reflected both in decision-making and in the enaction of the European backstop. As presidency, Greece will seek the appropriate compromises in order to achieve final agreement with the European Parliament on the Single Resolution Mechanism by April. About migration, borders and mobility. Instability in the European periphery, together with the perseverance of the causes that lead to immigration flows into Europe, increase these flows and place an extra burden on EU member states. In a period of economic crisis, this burden falls mainly on the EU member states that are on Europe's external borders, on the east and mainly the south, as well as on those heavily affected by recession and unemployment. Coincidentally, on several occasions, some EU countries fall on both of those categories. In this context, the Hellenic Presidency will concentrate its efforts on highlighting the positive aspects of a comprehensive migration management in order to boost growth and in promoting all dimensions of migration and mobility policies. At the same time, action is envisaged to tackle the problems arising from illegal migration. More specifically, our approach has three main aims, and those within the framework of the EU global approach to migration, the relevant EU policies, as well as the EU cooperation with third countries. First, to stop or reduce at least illegal migration in an efficient way while safeguarding respect for human rights. Secondly, to improve and better organize legal migration and facilitate mobility. And thirdly, to enhance synergies between migration and growth. On fighting illegal migration, we will focus on readmission and return, on fighting human trafficking and building institutional capacities for better border management in the process of updating the EU Action Plan for tackling migration pressure. Our objective is a comprehensive approach to border management while reinforcing preventive actions in countries of origin and transit of illegal immigrants. The Hellenic Presidency will promote the implementation of common European asylum system and will put emphasis on solidarity measures and on the need to increase European funding in order to assist those member states which are being affected the most by migration. Respect of obligations deriving from international treaties and EU law is imperative in this effort. Since mobility is a term broader than migration, it is necessary to link the external dimension of migration with interrelated policies, such as visa policies, strategic partnership, EU competitiveness, and the common migration policy, capable of contributing to the implementation of Europe 2020 agenda. The Task Force for the Mediterranean that was formed at the European Council in October is a right first step in the direction that the problem should be addressed to the extent possible at the place of origin. In view of the fast approach in end of the Stockholm Programme 2010 to 2014, the Hellenic Presidency will work on formulating the strategic vision and laying the priorities of EU-relevant policies covering the years 2014 to 2018, founded on solidarity, joint responsibility and cooperation between member states. Greece has made clear that it seeks measures for the promotion in practice of the fair sharing of responsibility. between the member states in immigration and asylum, a principle explicitly enshrined in the Lisbon Treaty and the Treaty of the Functioning of the EU. Greece considers that the recast of the Dublin regulation has proved less ambitious than it should have been, because, among others, it does not give real answers to the worries and pressing problems which some member states face in the external borders of the EU. Greece also believes that there should be legislative initiatives on the part of the EU which would display genuine and practical solidarity to those member states which are particularly affected by extraordinary inflows from the external borders, given the provision of Article 80 of the Treaty of the Functioning of the EU. Greece, especially under the current circumstances of the intensification of migratory inflows and the tragic events in many areas of the Mediterranean, believes that the migration is a major political issue for the EU, which cannot be tackled within the existing structures and the existing legal framework or the existing financial allocations or even the existing possibilities of Frontex. Completely new initiatives should be undertaken concerning the magnitude of their ambition. At the same time, a larger financing is required or relevant actions, while at the same time a different attitude should prevail concerning European solidarity and, by extension, fair burden sharing. Under this angle, Greece will undertake initiatives for a more systematic advancement of its long-term stance, which aims at a fair and efficient distribution of burdens, but also, most importantly, at a humanitarian and efficient treatment of migratory flows. Finally, it is to be noted that an horizontal priority of the Hellenic presidency is the comprehensive maritime policy. While an important position is given to border management, citizen security and protection, and to the migration policies. Allow me here to expand your knowledge with a few data. The number of illegal immigrants that entered EU via Greek land borders in 2013 was 75% less than in 2012. The number of illegal immigrants that entered EU via Greek sea borders in 2013 were 500 more than in 2012. Greece hosts about 2,000 Syrians, to which a six-month residence permit is granted on humanitarian grounds, which may be renewed. Moreover, in dealing with the Syrian humanitarian crisis, Greece implements the international standards and the practices applicable to the case of citizens who are in need, in close cooperation with the European institutions. Those Syrians applying for any international protection are given swift status. Today, as Europe is being plagued by the economic crisis, it is essential to reinforce the common European policy on the areas of justice and home affairs. Such a common policy must be founded on solidarity, joint responsibility, cooperation between member states. Now, maritime policies. Being a traditionally maritime country, Greece recognizes the great potential that marine and maritime activities have of benefiting the EU economy. At the same time, Europe has strategic interests that justify the urge to deal with security problems of sea border management. In this context, Greece introduces an horizontal thematic, namely the EU maritime policy, that will run through all three of the presidency's priorities. The main idea is to redefine and restart the EU maritime policy in all its aspects, building upon the work of Cyprus presidency, the Limassol Declaration of 2012. Our objective will be the adoption of a text on maritime policy strategy at the June 2014 European Council, highlighting two dimensions, security and growth. In this context, the Hellenic presidency will focus to the following actions. It's a long list. One, build on the integrated maritime policy in the marine and maritime agenda for growth and jobs, including seabed mapping, blue energy, aquaculture, blue biotechnology, environmental issues, and exploitation of marine mineral resources, as well as developing the indigenous energy resources of the European Union as an additional factor of reducing Europe's energy dependence. Two, push for implementation of maritime spatial planning. Three, update the EU maritime strategy on maritime transport in light of the recent international developments. Four, adopt EU strategy for the Adriatic and Ionian seas. Maritime and marine growth, transport, environment and tourism consist of the four pillars of the USAR. The Commission is expected to adopt the communication and the action plan during spring 2014. The Hellenic Presidency considers the EU macro-region strategy for the Adriatic and Ionian Seas region an important priority, and in this context will organize a ministerial meeting. Five, shape a European maritime security strategy. The preparations are underway. Our goal is the adoption of the strategy during our presidency at the June 2014 European Council. Six, promote cooperation and synergies of Coast Guard services. 7. Promote nautical and coastal tourism. 8. Deal appropriately with the sensitive but ultimately important issue for European security of seaborne migration. Our goal is to promote these issues in the framework of the third priority, migration, borders and mobility. While the dissolution of the European Parliament in May means that we have a tight schedule to keep during the first trimester of our presidency, as far as legislative work is concerned, the second trimester is going to be equally busy, as it provides a good opportunity to have political strategic debates on the most pressing issues and reach the political guidance and direction of the next trio presidency. Already, we are working very closely with Italy in order to have a smooth transition from one trio presidency to another and ensure that the necessary follow-up work will be taken forward. Your Excellencies, members of the Institute, distinguished guests, I can assure you that my country, having already undertaken the rotating presidency four times, is fully aware of the actual climate within the EU and the relevant difficulties. Greece has the know-how as well as the sensitivities and the necessary perception of reality that can guarantee a successful presidency in the interest of all European citizens. Thank you very much.